What's going on, guys? CWG here. Welcome to episode 43 of the Vault Hunters SMP. Did you know movie 43 was one of the worst movies of all time? I actually had to look this up. It got like a 4% on Rotten Tomatoes. Anyway, guys, welcome to the episode. I'm so excited for this one. We finally get to build a train and use all these tracks we've been building for the past few episodes. Who's ready to ride across the bridge of friendship? I know I am. But first, let me show you guys what I've been working on in between episodes. As you can see, we're level 46 now. We have ran a few vaults in between. Quick update for our skill situation. I'm starting to put levels into tank. Now, right now, our tank is only like 5 seconds, but as you upgrade it, it gets better. And I'm kind of curious, how good does tank get when it's a higher level? Like, at lower levels, not the best, but you can't always judge a book by its cover. So I want to start upgrading tank, see how good it gets. Now, as for mech create stuffs and things, I did add another machine. Welcome to the gravel washing machine. It takes your gravel, it washes it, and then it stores the items in a drawer. Now, this thing does make flint, which doesn't have too many uses. Actually, I forgot. There's flint blocks. Actually, are these like cool looking? Ooh, I like these blocks. I think we may have to start building with flint in the future. I like that. But it also gives us iron. So this is basically an iron farm. Nice. And I even set up a switch using modular routers. I call it the iron switch. It grabs the gravel from this drawer and sends it to the chest over there. Pretty neat. Why is this wheel not spinning? There's a gearbox missing in there. What? Someone steal my gearbox? You know what really grinds my gears? When people steal my gearboxes. Okay, now it's working. That is really weird that just disappeared like that. Anyways, let's go to the rail tunnel. Oh, that's funny. Code moved all the solar panels out here because I may have covered them by the bridge. Whoa, these solar panels make noise? I never noticed that before. I'll have to turn up the sound in the video, but it kind of makes a humming sound. Oh. Alright, anyways, let's get up here. So I haven't decorated the tunnel yet, but I have made it taller because we found out we want to build some pretty decent sized trains and they're going to need a lot of room. Like, we're going to have to remove some of these blocks up here too. And right here is where our train station is going to be. Making this was kind of difficult because you can't attach a track to a sloped track. And we have our dragon's lair right here. So we had barely enough room to squeeze a cross track right here. And then we're gonna have it turn over here and the train station is gonna be along this direction. Because actually, I kind of dug through this to show you, the dragon's lair is right here. So there was barely enough room to squeeze a train station in here. Sometimes things were meant to be. So you want to build a train, huh? Well, the first thing we're going to need is a train station. And it looks like you right-click a compass onto a train casing. To get a train casing, you right-click a sturdy sheet onto a brass casing. Okay, we know how to make brass casings. How do we make the sturdy sheet? Oh, it's a process. Looks like it takes one lava squirt and two stamp. Okay, and we have to use powdered obsidian, which, yeah, you could just use the crushing wheels. Okay, we already have that set up. So I'm going to work on setting up a lava squirt double stamp, and I'll be right back. Hello there. Did you expect me here in the end? Well, we're here for a specific reason. We need a lot of obsidian to make a lot of those sturdy sheets, and yeah, it looks like someone else has already been doing this. But using the end pillars is an amazing source of obsidian. Pair it up with vein mine, and you can get a ton of obsidian really quickly. Now, once we get into thermal expansion, they have a pretty nice way of getting obsidian from lava. But until then, we're mining by hand, baby. Also, I like that the end just has random bits of water and snow around. Someone also built like a cool little path that goes through one of the pillars. Why is there a random well here? I don't know. I don't know who built this. Oh, I see. This leads to where you spawn in for the end. Okay. Wait, what are these? End brick arrow slits? Wait, there's arrow slits in the game where you can like shoot your bow through? Yeah, apparently there's like 7 different types of arrow slit blocks you can make. You can make like a stone one, cobblestone. Oh, that's cool. All right, I'll keep that in mind. There's so many cool building blocks in modded Minecraft. You kind of have to like write them down whenever you see something cool. For instance, these coral endstone bricks look really cool. And they're crafted with endstone brick and chorus fruit. Really cool block. All right, we're getting distracted. Let's go back to Mech Create Island. So as you can see, I added a machine here. We got the lava squirt and the double stamp. Now, we have to crush down our obsidian first. So we should just be able to yeet a stack of obsidian up here and it should get crushed. And look at that, we're getting powdered obsidian and we're also getting normal obsidian back? Is that normal? Oh, you actually get a 75% chance to get the obsidian back. That's cool. Well, let's test out this machine and see if we get a sturdy sheet. So you throw one on, it gets squirt, stamp, stamp, boom, sturdy sheet. Nice. Achievement made, the sturdiest of rocks. Let's go ahead and make a stack of these. Why not? We have the materials. All right, this is kind of satisfying to watch. Boom, 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 boom. Beatboxing with C-dubs. So we should be able to take a chromatic iron block, turn it into a brass casing, and then turn it into train casing, the logistical age. Oh, baby. Fuzzy says train in the chat. Yas. So the next thing we're going to need is a train station. Oh yeah, I already said that. We have to put a compass on. I forgot. It's been that long already. Becometh the train station. Oh, I mean, it's a train station. Now, I'm going to need a lot more train casings to make the train itself, which means I'm going to need a lot of brass, and I'm pretty much out of brass now. To get brass, we have to mix copper and zinc, but I am out of zinc. I wonder if anyone else on the server has some zinc. All right, guys, I'm down in the mines, zinc hunting with the boys. Just kidding. It's just me. I'm alone. But I'm just running around these caves looking for zinc pockets because I haven't really mined them before. And I will say, the pickering makes this much easier. You just have to scan the walls, look for some zinc, like, oh, there's some zinc up there. And you can just vein mine it with the pickering. Oh, that's so convenient. Look, I see some zinc down there. You think this will reach? Of course it reaches. We should be able to get all the zinc we need in no time. I'm back out of the mines. You want to see some satisfying fortuning of all this zinc? We're going to be able to make so many train casings out of these bad boys. It's going to be amazing. Oh my gosh, we got almost 9 stacks of raw zinc there. That's really good. Now all we gotta do is run all this raw zinc through the crushing wheels. And I believe it's gonna also drop some experience cubes. Yeah, check these out. Nuggets of experience. I think if you like right click it, yeah, it gives you straight up XP. Kinda cool. It'll be useful later when we need some levels. So I'm gonna process through the zinc. I'm gonna make a bunch more brass and I'll meet you guys back at the train station. And we're back at the train station, or what will become the train station. Right now, it's just kind of a hole underground. So all we gotta do is take our train station, put it right here, make sure it's facing that way, because I want the train to go out that way. After you select it, I believe you just set it down here, and boom! We have our train station, which is kind of like the waypoint system for tracks. This is where we can actually build our train. So let's start off and create new train. Oh! As you can see, a little bit of blue shows up on the track. That shows you where to place the train casing. And if we place it down, you can see it makes a bogey. Yeah, this is called a bogey, apparently. And you can change the design by right-clicking with the wrench. Oh, now it's a bit sussy. And then if you right-click it again, it goes back. So that's our two designs we can use. We could also add more bogeys if we put more down on the blue. Like, you can make absolutely big trains. It's ridiculous. Now, in between episodes, I've actually been working on a design for a train. So let's go hop into the creative world. Welcome to my creative test world. Ready for the train reveal? Train reveal? Boom! This is the train that I came up with, and oh, I love this thing. It's got a flywheel in the front. Yep, circles in Minecraft. Thanks to Fuzzy for giving me the idea to do this. It's also got some grind wheels here to make up the engine. This right here is a cool little trick, using shaft and shaft clamps to make it look like it's pipes going into the engine. Oh, this is so cool. I even put little fairy lights on the front so it will illuminate the way as the train goes. And yes, this thing has a working train whistle. It's so awesome. So the first carriage here is the driver's carriage. We could come in, take a seat, and then operate the train from right here. How awesome is that? Now in this chest, you could actually put coal in it. And if you have like flammable stuff in a chest in your train, it'll make the train go even faster. Awesome. And our back carriage here is for the passengers. We have 12 seats in here, so there's enough to seat the whole server in this train. I have some shaft bars going off the top. This is where you can like hang up your jacket, hang up your coat, put your suitcase up on the top, and then take a seat in the train and go along for the ride. These walls here are actually frame trap doors that I colored to black stainless glass. That way you can look out the window. Because what's the point of being on a train if you can't witness the amazing view from outside, right? And I actually put two doors in here, and you can walk from one carriage to the other. Now, this is a bit dangerous to do while the train's moving, but still something you can do. Now, the one thing I kind of regret with this train is I used so many of these train casings, and I now realize that each of these train casings cost a block of brass. So I may have to mine even more zinc. I'm hoping we're gonna have enough. At least the trap doors only need one brass sheet, so those are a little bit better. I even built one of those like linky things on the back to make it look like it can link to another train. I mean, we can add more carriages in the future, but this is what I got. So I'm gonna take a schematic and quill here, so that way we can figure out how many materials we're gonna need so we can build this on the server. And we'll save it as train. All right, well, let's get back to the server then. All right, we're back at the server. Let's grab a schematic and quill and get our train uploaded. Train, upload. Oh my, this thing's actually gonna be pretty big. I may have to make this track bigger. Let's just plop it down and see what happens. Oh my gosh, this thing looks way bigger when it's in the server. Oh my goodness. We're gonna have to make this tunnel way taller. This thing is huge. Okay, let me go grab the schematic cannon to figure out how many materials we're gonna need. Oh, I can't wait to build this thing. I'm freaking out, guys. It feels like everything's been leading up to this moment of building this train, and I cannot wait to ride it around.
Dear schematic cannon, please tell me the materials that I'm gonna need.
Material checklist. All right, well, I'm gonna be spending some time and crafting all these things we're gonna need. Okay, how many train casings am I gonna need? 57 train casings, so that's 57 blocks of brass. Oh my goodness. And even more for the train trapdoor. Now, here's something very important. Remember how there's a bunch of frame trapdoors in the build? We're gonna have to place those by hand because apparently it will crash the server if you try to use the frame blocks with the schematic cannon. So I'm gonna gather everything we need except for the frame blocks, and we'll be right back. All right, so I got everything that I think we need inside of this shulker here. And I have all the frame block stuff I need in this shulker that we're gonna be using afterwards. Now, someone in the comments showed me something cool. You can actually run your material checklist through the cannon again, and it will cross off the stuff that you have. It'll put a little bit of a check mark. For instance, we're missing polished deep slate slabs. What? Oh, we put in polished cut deep slate slabs. How silly of me. See, that's why this thing's useful. All right, let's provide the slabs and check again. Looks like we're good here. Good, 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 and good, and good. Sweet. Which means there's nothing left to do but to start the build. Begin. There it goes. All right, so let's hop into a satisfying time lapse of building the train. And it's done. Oh, baby, look at it. All right, we really need to make this like way bigger of a room. It is so cramped in here with this train. Let me dig into the side a little bit. So what I need to do now is go around and place all the frame blocks. And then I think the train should be like ready to go. I'm excited. And I did it, guys. I did the thing. I put in the glass trap doors everywhere so that way you could look outside. I made a little bit of a bridge so you could walk into the door. Yeah, this is why I wanted to build the train first, because I wasn't exactly sure where these parts would connect so that way I know how to build the train station. But everything should be good to go now. Let's grab our super glue, because this part's actually kind of important. We want to make sure that this part's all glued together and this part's all glued together. And the schematic cannon actually does a great job of putting the glue in the right spots. I mean, I don't see an issue. Oh yeah, I put underglow under this thing. You like it? These are the dynamic edge lights, which can be crafted with glowstone and stone. And thankfully we have the witch egg now, so glowstone is no longer an issue. Does your train have underglow? Didn't think so. All right, so I think everything's good now. We could assemble the train. I'm a bit nervous about this. I hope it works. We just have to click the assemble button. Boop. Frontmost bogey must be at station marker. Oh no, did I build it in the wrong spot? I am not shifting this whole thing over. Although I think we can move the train station itself to here. Then, okay, now will you let me assemble? Oh, I think we got it. All aboard! Achievement get! Oh, it's beautiful. Fuzzy says woohoo! Oh man, we're gonna drive some trains soon. Alright, I'm gonna give it a test drive, and then we're gonna meet up with the squad, and then like drive this thing together. Okay, there's no coal in here now, so it's not gonna operate at high speeds, but let's take control of the train. Switch into F5 mode, because it's easier to tell what's happening. Let's move forward. Look at it go! Oh, it's so cool! Oh, look! Dude, we need to make these tunnels bigger. It's so claustrophobic. Oh my goodness. Also, since we have a whistle, if I press the sprint button... Yeah! Advancement made, choo-choo! Alright, let's go visit Code, I say. Let's take the train to Code's base. Oh, look at it go! This thing is huge! Whoa! The view! The view! Oh my goodness. This is amazing. Alright, let's take a right here. Whee! I'm having so much fun! Alright, we're off to Code's base. Do-do-do-do! Let's go pick him up! This is so satisfying! Off we go! Sound the whistle! Code, we're here! Hello! Anybody home? Alright, to dismount the train, I believe we just leave the seat. Yep, stop controlling contraption. Let's get out here. This thing's so cool! Alright guys, so here's the plan. Fuzzy also has a train, so we're gonna back up into Fuzzy's train station, which he just built, so we're gonna have to check it out. It looks pretty cool. It's very dark and spooky in here. Also, I love that our train lights up because of the underglow. It looks so cool in Fuzzy's dark tunnel. Now, what we're gonna do is drive both our trains from Fuzzy's all the way to Peep's for as an opening ceremony. Alright, here we are in Fuzzy's train station. This is Fuzzy's train. Looking sick. How many seats are in here?
12 in both carriages.
Oh, well, nice.
In with the boat carriages.
We could fit our server and another server at this point. Let's go. Alright, you guys ready to drive across the server for the first time ever?
Let's do it.
Let's do it.
Let's open the tracks, blow the whistle. All aboard. Let's go.
Let's go. Look at it go.
Oh, baby.
Five here a little bit.
And rock.
It's hard to drive a train.
Yeah. Into the Code's garage. Whee!
Oh, this thing going goes so fast.
Yeah, I put blaze cakes into the chest and this thing books. All right, let's take a right. The scenic route.
Ooh.
Wow.
You can see Met Create Island. See all of the wonderful machines.
This is so sick. All right.
I don't
want to
crash into you guys.
Don't crash into us. Through the tunnel, whee! Across the bridge, friendship! Oh,
my
man.
My train is struggling. My train can't get up.
Your train can't get up?
Oh, no! Yeah. Look at the train!
Oh, man.
Oh, this is so incredible.
This is sick. Oh, he's straight up. There it is.
So look cool. At that!
Look at it go! Across the bridge of friendship.
Bridge of friendship. It looks so cool.
I have foreseen an issue.
Yeah?
My train is twice as long as yours.
Oh.
We should be okay.
We're going to have to do... All right, let's do some tricky maneuvering here, okay?
I'll supervise from out here.
Yeah. I'll back up into the thing, and then you're going to have to move forward while I'm backed into it.
I think I'm reversing all the way home.
This is train logistics. All right, now you move forward.
Code, tell me if I'm going off the edge.
You're good. It'll stop you.
Yeah.
That's true, yeah.
Alright, there. Now there should be enough room for me to get out. Okay, now you back into it.
Wait. Oh, the doors are on the wrong side of the station, of the train.
Oh,
I can't get in.
No, you don't have a door on both sides?
Okay, I am in your train now, Fuzzy.
Is it this way or the other
way? Back and hit right.
You missed it.
Are you hitting the right?
No, I hit left.
Yeah.
Yeah, you hit it right.
Come on, it's like I'm actually driving. You have to...
But I'm like, looking at it the other way around.
Alright, here he goes. Okay.
There we go. Alright, let's see if I can do this. Hold on. Let's see if I can
fly in the train.
Yeah.
Oh,
got it. Nice. Nailed it.
The first traffic jam of the server.
Yeah. All right, here we go. All aboard.
If anybody is in the carriages, whenever you go into the wall like that, it does give damage. Look at how fast.
Yeah.
Whee.
Whee. Dude, I could ride circles around Mecreate Island all day.
Whee.
I cannot see where you are at the moment. You're going to code.
Backing up. Oh, dude, it takes time to shift the inertia.
Need some brakes.
We need emergency brakes.
Or are we letting Fuzzy go first?
It'll be fine.
Fair.
Was that switch the trains around? Oh, hi, Fuzzy. Wait. Oh, no. Brakes.
Oh, no.
Derailed train. Oh, wait. That's a real thing. what do we do? Use wrench to relocate.
Freak him. Oh, look at the. Oh,
the train's been derailed.
I need a screenshot of that.
Hold on. Yeah. Look at this.
Oh, that's crazy. Even the tracks are
phantoms.
Oh, wow. They are all after you, Fuzzy.
Now it's like Ohio in real life.
I have a thing. Sleep charm.
They are all after you. They're right on top of your train.
How am I supposed to get out? Oh. I'm stuck in the driver's cockpit. I can't get out.
Can we get out?
I can't get out at this angle, dude. I'm stuck.
I can't get
out. Oh, I got out. Okay.
Okay.
So it said we need to use the wrench to relocate the train. Oh, wait, Code, did you see the achievement you got? Terrible service. Witness a train crash as a passenger. Hit an advancement. We got to hit an advancement.
That's hilarious.
All right, so right click to pick up train. And then I should be able to okay. Now is it working now? Is it fixed? Train, do you work? Yay, it works again.
Okay.
All right. Well, I'm going to bring my train back home. Well, this means the railways are officially open for business.
Yep.
Let's go.
I'm stuck.
Yeah, you can drive it around if you want, Code. I'll go in the carriage.
It's a pretty good view from back there.
Well, the passenger view is kind of nice. Okay, you can see the Dragon Slayer.
Yeah.
The beautiful view of Mecreate. I think my favorite part is the Bridge of Friendship, the view you get from up there.
Yeah, this is so cool. So I'm taking it up through here again.
The Bridge of Friendship.
Yeah, wow. That's pretty nice.
What a view. I feel like we're in Hogwarts, when the train's on that really elevated thing and the car's flying around it. There's a zombie on the track.
I'm holding it here.
All right, where is it?
Right here, straight ahead.
All right, time to hit the zombie. Let's go! Roadkill! Oh, I forgot to turn. Hey!
What if you kill a player?
I don't know.
I'm sure that's probably the same.
Beep! Whoa!
Jeez. It just pushed me.
Fuzzy's indestructible. Oh!
Oh!
Fuzzy was ran over by unnamed train.
Fuzzy was run over. Your body's just laying there.
I'm guessing that's what happens.
Well, guys, we did it. The train station is open. Where are we going to link up to next?
I think we need to finally make it to Evat. Otherwise, we're kind of just literally going around in circles.
Yeah, a small circle, Yeah, not like server circles, but small circles around the island. Yeah.
Yep.
Yeah.
Next up is linking up to Evat.
It's beautiful, but we really need to go north.
We need to go north.
Super exciting. We need to get Zinjy station built over on his side as well. And then we'll have connections. We'll have connections everywhere.
Yeah.
It's so exciting.
Well, guys, that was an absolute blast. Let me know in the comments what you guys think about the train. And also, we need to come up with a name for the train. So leave a comment and the most upvoted one I'll have become the name of the train. But I'm definitely going to have my work cut out for me the next few days, making this train station look cool. It's going to be a lot of work on that one. It's 24 minutes into this video and we haven't even touched a vault crystal yet. Wow. Let's change that. Let's go ahead and make one and see what we need to get. Carrots easy, copper easy, stone easy, arrows easy, nice. Let's see how quickly I can submit these items. Done.
Thank you. What do we got inside our bounty table? Oh, that's right. We have to submit chromatic iron and we get a bunch of XP and some more chromatic iron. Wait, we almost get all of the chromatic iron back. That's kind of hilarious. I've actually been spending so much chromatic iron on the train stuffs and things. I think I ended up using like over 1,000 chromatic iron on that. But don't worry, we still got 1,000 chromatic iron ore that we've yet to fortune. So I'm not too worried about running out of this stuff. Let's claim reward. Nice. And what do we get? An axe. Roll it. And it's just a common with tier 2 damage. Goodbye. Let's go ahead and select this quest. Find 35 Larimar. It may take one or two vaults, but you get 2 Echo Gems. Not going to turn down 2 Echo Gems. So let's go hop into the vault and get some Larimar. Looks like we got a scav vault, and that's a lot of stuff. Although, it is possible if we find a bunch of coin piles. It'll be tricky for sure. But we're more interested in finding Larimar anyway, so that's okay. Ooh, look at this POI. I've not seen this one before. It's kind of a more red dragon with a coppery wing. It's kind of cute. It does contain a bunch of coins, though, and we need that for those blood vials. In fact, I think I just saw us get one right there. Pretty good. Yep, and we already got 4 blood vials. That was quick. And there's some more nate chests over here, so maybe we'll even get the sack that we need. You know what? I will not give up on the scav vault. We will get it. Give me my sack. No sack in there. Oh, we got the sack right there. Okay, sweet. Ooh, first ore POI. I already see the Larrys. I need 35 of you guys so I could get some echo, please. Ooh, Xenium, aka fake echo. All right, we should be able to complete a Idona altar here. Maybe we could get another Idona favor. That would be cool. And do we get lucky? Nope, just a blessing. Oh no, we got an idol. Let's go, level 46 idol. Oh, we got the other skeleton bone shard we need. Okay, I think the only thing we're missing now is ripped pages. And how many ripped pages do we have? We have 10. The issue is I forgot to empty my scav pouch last time I did a scav vault. So it's kind of a mess in my inventory. But we literally just need 6 more ripped pages and we're good. We just need to find a bunch of wooden chests. Is this a dungeon in here? It is, and it's an ore one too, so maybe that'll help us get that Larimar ore we need. Although we need to be quick, because we still need to get 6 ripped pages, and I want to get that scav ghost walk. Whoa, that did a lot of damage really quickly. And that's why we have ghost walk, kids. Alright, finally got the spawner. You better have a good amount of Larimar in here. Yes, a little bit of Larimar. Omega, only 5 pages left. Alright guys, we just need 2 more ripped pages. Omega, any ripped pages in here? Let's check. Oh, they both have ripped pages, we're up to 16 now. Oh, we got it. We only got 6 minutes left anyway, so I say we just submit and bounce. We got 38 green mob essence in that vault. That's a bit bananas. And now we submit our 16 ripped pages. I can't believe we actually got that. Let's go. We got 11,000 XP, 107 chests broken. Dang, that might be a record. I'll have to start keeping track of that number. Give me a sec to smelt down all these scav items before I forget. Well, while things are smelling down, let's roll these pieces of gear. Ooh, Shadow King chest plate. So we got an idol with only 6% affinity. Lame. It can't even beat our 7% one. Bye bye. Next we got an axe with 21 attack damage and 4 chaining. Ooh. I'll keep that one around. That's a nice backup. And the chest plate got really bad implicits. Ugh. Bye bye. Alright, let's pop open our scav crate, see if we got anything good. I see some jewels in there and some more armor. 14 refined carbon. Nice. A bit of lemon. Might come in useful later. Fundamental foci are always nice. The jewel has axing and it's kind of mid-size. 2 more pieces of gear. Bad boots, bad helmet. Oh wow, another decent axe. 188% soul chance on this one. Oh, this would be a great soul shard farming axe. We're starting to get better and better rolls on these weapons. You'll love to see it. And with that, it's meme of the day time. Today's meme comes from MCU's from the Discord. Wasn't me. I like that you photoshopped the cube inside of the hand. Nice attention to detail. And with that, thank you guys so much for watching. I'll catch you guys in the next one. CWG out.